I'm going to show you how to turn a PDF, a doc that you have in your Google Drive, or even a YouTube video into this.
LinkedIn Live can feel a little complicated, right? But what if I told you that you could use it to reach thousands of potential clients for free every single week? Every single week. For free.
And we're going to do this with Google Notebook LM. As of late August 2025, Google Notebook LM has video overviews in over 80 languages. The first step is to go to notebooklm.google.com, and you'll see this right on the screen. If you do not have an account, all you have to do is click try now and then sign in with a Gmail email. Once you do that, you'll be taken to a screen that looks like this. Then I want you to click create new notebook. Once you click create new notebook, it's going to ask you to either upload sources or to discover sources. Sources let NotebookLM base its responses on the information that matters to you most. The main thing to understand is that whatever you put into this notebook will be the sources that are used to create the video overview that we are going to create. If I wanted to create a video overview on how to go live on video on LinkedIn, and then I start to put in sources that have to do with LinkedIn newsletters or our upcoming masterclass, ChatGPT for Small Business Owners, it's not going to make sense to put those sources in here because it's going to convolute and going to muddy the waters when it comes to the video overview. I'm adding things that really have nothing to do with going live on video on LinkedIn. I only want to upload sources that have to do with the topic or with whatever I want covered in the audio overview. Personally, I have quite a few sources on going live on video on LinkedIn. What I could do is I could provide the links to those because they are YouTube videos. But in the event that they were Google Docs, I would just click Docs or Slides, or I could actually copy any text from a Word document or whatever. Because it is a YouTube video, I'm going to click YouTube and paste the URL. That specific YouTube video is literally how to go live on video on LinkedIn. I do have other corresponding sources to that. So for example, I have a video called Can You Pre-Record LinkedIn Live Video? Why would I add that to the notebook? It has to do with the information that I'm providing inside of this notebook. Here's the notebook. Here's my one source. All I would have to do to add more sources is click add up here on the top left and do the same thing. Scroll down, click YouTube, and paste the new video. What it will do is then add that as a second source. Then I have this one, LinkedIn Live Video for Business, top 3 mistakes to avoid. Again, it has to do with the information relevant to this notebook. Once you've added all of your sources, what you're going to do is go over here to the top right and click Video Overview. It will generate an explainer video presented to you by AI. I'm going to click that, and it says generating video. This may take a while. The video overview has completed with 3 sources. It took about 5 minutes to complete. As you could see, with the 3 sources, it came out to 6 minutes long. I'm going to listen to about 30 seconds of it and see if the intro and the material is good, and then we'll go from there.
You know, LinkedIn Live can feel, well, a little complicated, right? But what if I told you that you could use it to reach thousands of potential clients for free every single week? Well, in the next few minutes, we're going to break down exactly how you can do that. And it all kicks off with one very important number. So what's so special about this number? 1,000? Well, that's the number of your first degree connections you can invite to a LinkedIn Live event every single week.
I'm pretty impressed. She did a better job than me when presenting this information, because the thing that sets LinkedIn Live video events apart from other social media platforms and that gives it its power, especially if you're someone with more than 4,000 connections on LinkedIn, which I want to know if you are, put the number of followers or connections that you have in the comments, and feel free to send a LinkedIn connection request. I'm happy to connect with you. But the 1,000 number is critical because what LinkedIn Live video events allow you to do is invite 1,000 people to your live video events every week. that gives it its power, because in a month you can invite 4,000. And if 800 click attend, 100 at least will show up, giving you the opportunity to create a live video event every single month with an audience of 100 people live. And if you have 100 of the right people live and you know what you're doing when it comes to delivery and presentation and messaging, it becomes an improbability for you to not get 3 to 5 calls and for you to not close one very high ticket client. And this is the type of math that I present and that we really rely on when it comes to working with my one-on-one clients, where just one client for them is $100,000, $250,000 additional in their business because they have very high ticket offers and they're doing 12 to 18 month contracts and they help organizations. Just how it's presented and how we're getting to the main point at the 30-second mark is impressive. And the fact that she's doing it with enthusiasm in her voice, most humans cannot do this. Let's listen to another 30 seconds and then go from there.
For free. I mean, just let that sink in for
us for
a second. See, that's the real power of LinkedIn Live. And we're going to show you exactly how to tap into this because it's a tool that's so powerful, but honestly, it's pretty misunderstood. It's not just about hitting some go live button. It's about having a smart strategy. And that starts with knowing who you're talking to. Look, it's one thing to reach a bunch of people, but it's another thing entirely to reach the right people. And that's where LinkedIn is just a total game changer.
This is so true. Remember, it's not just making this up. If I would have said 70% are decision makers or 60% are decision makers, then it would have showed that statistic. The reason that it's good is because it has good sources, and so it's easy to follow along with. This is why in your long-form video presentations or in your podcast or in whatever sources that you put in here, the material has to be easy for the AI to understand and to organize. So far, so good. The visuals could be better. Could the branding be a little bit better? Could the first slide include a LinkedIn logo? Yes. But the material is on point, and I'm even learning some things on how to logically make things flow with my presentation, because usually I will actually share this data point first and then talk about the 1,000. But just listening to how it reorganized my thoughts, I may just switch it. And so this is an opportunity for you to put in your sources, to put in how you have your presentation flow, and to see how AI could potentially compress it to 6 minutes, number one, to take out things that may be redundant, number two, and to reorganize it in a way that could be more compelling. Once you have your overview here, you can download it. So I just downloaded it. And then what can I do with the download? I can embed it into a blog post. I could leverage the transcript to put into a GPT, Custom Growth Academy Bundle GPTs that we have, to turn it into LinkedIn newsletters or emails. I could even throw it into Descript and then change the voice and make the voice mine with a little bit of AI training. Maybe I'll do a completely separate video on that. But the point is, if the information is good, the flow is good, then I want to at least leverage that transcript. And for me personally, I'm at least turning that into a LinkedIn newsletter article, maybe a new video that I shoot. It could even be leveraged into a video script.